Dr. Jason Saunders here with HBOT USA. Our next question is, well, what's the difference between hyperbaric oxygen and just breathing from an oxygen tank, or hyperbaric oxygen and EWOT? EWOT is exercise with oxygen therapy. So it's another popular oxygenating tool out there. So we have to go back to one of the earlier questions, which is, how does hyperbaric oxygen even work? Because if you compared hyperbaric oxygen to breathing on an oxygen concentrator or breathing from a green tank of oxygen, you have to remember this. Oxygen under normal pressure, under one atmosphere, what you and I are at right now while you're listening to this video, relies completely on red blood cell carrying capacity, which means if right now you're about 97% saturated, witnessed by, you know, a pulse oximeter, you would say that if I had a green tank of oxygen or an oxygen concentrator, I can go from 97% to 100%. So I can get 3% more. Remember that because you're in a pressurized environment with hyperbaric, you're bypassing the red blood cell carrying capacity completely. And by doing that, you're massively increasing the amount of oxygen that we're able to absorb because we're dissolving oxygen directly into the plasma of the blood, again, bypassing red blood cell carrying capacity. So rather than a 3% increase that you could with a green tank of medical oxygen or an oxygen concentrator, you're talking many, many hundreds of times more oxygen because of pressure and because of the extra oxygen that we could absorb while in that pressurized environment. Now, let's compare hyperbaric oxygen to EWOT, exercise with oxygen therapy. For those that don't know what that is, picture you're basically exercising. It's usually on a bike, a stationary bike, and you're hooked up to a mask with not pure oxygen, not 100% oxygen, but like 95, 96% oxygen. And so you're exercising and breathing 96% oxygen instead of right now, let's say air is 21% oxygen. And so if you exercise and breathe higher percentage of oxygen, the question is, can you absorb more? Well, yeah, of course. Why? Because everybody knows that as they exercise, their heart rate goes up and their respiratory rate goes up. Why does that happen? Because as you're exercising, you're creating an oxygen demand. You're saying, hey, my body's moving now and I need to bring more oxygen to that working tissue. Let's say if you're on a bike, that's to your legs. And so as you need to deliver higher levels of oxygen to your legs, you start breathing faster so that you can get rid of carbon dioxide and bring in more oxygen. And your heart rate increases so that as your heart pumps faster, you can pump that blood to the working tissue. So EWOT works by increased demand through exercise and then an increase in supply through breathing the mask and breathing 96% oxygen versus 21% oxygen, which is what's in air. So does that work to increase oxygen in our body? Absolutely, 100% yes. Increased demand, increased supply. There's an increased red blood cell turnover. I'm dumping more oxygen into the system. I'm exhaling more carbon dioxide. And now I'm breathing in higher levels of oxygen. So yes, that definitely works. The differences, again, are with EWOT, even though you're increasing demand and you're increasing supply, and as a result, overall, you're increasing oxygenation of the body, you're still relying completely on red blood cell carrying capacity. So the amount that your red blood cells are able to dump carbon dioxide, attach oxygen, and then how quickly your heart can pump the blood, that still is determining how much oxygenation you can create. In a hyperbaric chamber, it's passive, it's not active, so you're actually just laying down and breathing. And as a result of that pressurized environment, depending on how much pressure you're using and how much extra oxygen you're using, the amount of oxygen absorption is many hundreds of times more than that tank of oxygen that you're breathing, but also many hundreds of times more even than EWOT, because even though you're passive, as you're dissolving oxygen directly into the plasma of the blood, the plasma can hold so much more oxygen than the red blood cells are able to. And so as a result, the total surplus of oxygen created by hyperbaric oxygen is many, many times the amount that you could get with EWOT, and which is many more times than the amount that you could get just breathing a mask of oxygen through a concentrator or medical green tank oxygen.